How you doing? How you been? What's going on? What's good? How you getting in? Body feeling funny? What's going on, people?
What's going on, people? I come to you with an update in reference to the transgender woman that was murdered in New York City. They said it was a homicide. Now, before we talked about this story, I told you, I said that they said it was a transgender woman that was murdered, but they never gave out a name. Now, as of today, I got a name. Her name was Brenda Bostick. Now, she was 59 years old. Now, the problem with this story still relies on there is no picture. Now, it's allegedly stated that she's a woman of color, and I'm going to let you hear what happened in reference to her as far as information I found. I want to share with you. Check this out.
Okay, here is an update. Brenda Bostick is the 10th trans woman murdered in the U.S. this year. Now, Bostick's body was discovered in Manhattan, Chelsea neighborhood after suffering a massive blow to the head in New York City. The transgender woman was found dead on Thursday, marking the 10th reported murder of a transgender woman of color. Now, according to the New York Post, Brenda was discovered unconscious in the Chelsea neighborhood of Manhattan about a half an hour after someone had called the police to report assault in progress. The officers arrived and declared that Brenda had been struck in the head with a heavy object, and she was rushed to Bellevue Hospital, where she eventually died from complications. A medical examiner later determined that the cause of death was homicide. The transgender woman was a target all too often severe of deadly violence in New York City Anti-Violence Project Executive Director Beverly Tillery in a statement. We are facing a crisis of violence. 10 transgender women has been already killed so far in 2017, 9 who have been black, a transgender woman, and 1 woman was native, she included. As society, as we stop to epidemic in hiring trans women of color, making sure the safe place to live, and standing up when we hear them being demeaned and attacked simply by devouring their lives, the moment is to act now. Now, Brenda Bostick, she was 59 years old. Rest in peace, Brenda. Rest in peace.
Okay, you said August says, rest in peace, Brenda. Rest in peace. 59 years old. Now, allegedly, they were stating that someone had saw this attack taking place and they contacted the police. And when the police got in everything, they basically found her on the ground. You know, she was rushed to the hospital where she died from her injuries. Now, she was 59 years old, and they said it was an assault, you know, of course, upon her that murdered her and stuff. Now, still, I have not found the picture. Now, I kind of Googled it to try to find, you know, if I could find someone that was, you know, her caliber. Now, one thing I don't want to do is just grab a picture and say, okay, this is her. You know, because everybody has these names and stuff, and I don't want to just grab something, you know what I mean, and just put it out there. So I wanted to share this story with you as far as the update, as far as her slowly coming to our vision, as far as seeing who this woman was. You know, I don't understand how come the hospital or something didn't take a picture of her or something to let people know her whereabouts. Now, if she's the woman that's murdered, as far as, you know, being homeless and stuff, there should be some type of picture out here that we can relate to. Now, how could you contact the family if you have no pictures or nothing as far as, you know, information given out there as far as people could find a way to try to contact the family or something, somebody? If there's no picture, how can we help if we don't see anything as a, you know, just a name? You know, this has been a day within a day, within a day, within a day. You know, it's just so many unanswered things, you know, and I know we're not going to sing Kumbaya and everything is not going to go according to plan and where we wanted to work. I just don't understand how we get this piece by piece information. It's like, I'm gonna give y'all a little bit of this and see what y'all do. I'm gonna give y'all a little bit of that and I'm gonna see what y'all gonna do. You know, stop force feeding us the small amount of this woman's life. Her life was in entirety 59 years old to be killed on the street. Why do we have to wait for a picture? You saying contact the family. If you said she was homeless, how are you gonna contact the family if there was no information reference to, you know, a picture or something so we could kind of help out? You never know who may have known her. You never know who may know her location. You never know. See, this is the thing. She may have been homeless and she may have another family. You know, the family that kicks you out, that gets rid of you, you have to create a whole new family. You know, so she may have had another family. There could be a GoFundMe page. There could be a whole bunch of things that could be set up. We have no idea who this woman is. We got a name. So now we guess we have to wait to get a picture. I don't know if you get a picture or something. If you could put a link down here at the bottom, please share with me. I am over this whole thing. I am so upset because I can't understand why are we prolonging this information. Anyway, I just wanted to share this story with you as far as the update and stuff. I said more than I need to say as far as this. And just be careful out here if you decide to go out and stuff. Like I said before, if you get any information in reference to this woman's life, please let me know. And I want you to be safe. And I want you to know I love you. And I want to thank you for watching. Get some rain.